Hey, my name is Tom Turner and I'm going to talk to you today about the S.E.A.L method. Now, the S.E.A.L method isn't exactly a brand new idea. It was originally developed by a woman called Rosalind Wiseman in the States, but I've since adapted it to fit anti-bullying. This is something which can be used both in a setting where you are being bullied in the moment, but I also feel it can be used as something which you can use if you have developed a relationship, so to speak, with someone who is bullying you. Because often I have found that, you know, there'll be one person that has become your bully, and this is to solve that, or try and solve that relationship and diffuse that situation. So we'll start straight away with the first letter, that is S. And S stands for stop. Now, one of the key things in any situation is to be able to, you know, stop it, obviously. But this is more about stopping yourself than stopping the situation. If you can, and I know it's not always possible, but if you can, get out of the situation you're in. If someone is approaching you and that you have that knowledge that they are probably going to start picking you in some way, walk in the opposite direction, you can always turn back once they've gone on their way and stuff. Yeah, as I say, it's not always possible. I do understand that. I've been in that situation myself. But it's important to stop. But also stop stands for stop your brain. And I don't mean this in a stop thinking kind of way. But an awful lot of the time, you can get quite panicked in these situations and your brain goes into overdrive. And now that's quite a dangerous thing to happen in that situation, because one of the things, one of the reasons why people bully is because they like reaction. Now, when I was being bullied, I reacted quite badly, I overreacted, let's say, and that wasn't necessarily a good thing, and that encouraged people to bully me more. And though I'm not putting the onus on bullying on you, you know, it is not on you at all. You know, there are things you can do to help get out of that situation, and knowing how you're going to react is key, and stopping it if it is a bad reaction. So that is the first thing. So the next letter is E, and I'll come on to that in 1 second. Like stop, explain has quite a few facets to it, and it's not just a simple one thing to do. Basically, you have to explain a few things. You have to explain to the person that is picking on you how it makes you feel. Because, yeah, they might not always understand it, they might not get it, they might find it funny. But being that open and that honest might have quite a good impact. The other person you have to explain this to is a teacher, youth worker, or anyone that has some sort of authority in your life. Maybe it's a friend as well. You just explain to someone what is happening. What is, again, how it's making you feel. It doesn't necessarily mean that it's going to solve everything. Yeah. When I was being bullied, yeah, it went on for a number of years, and I wish that that doesn't happen to anyone watching this video. But one of the things was that I kept telling people, and I kept being ignored. And that sadly does happen, and I might address that in a future video. But knowing there are people out there, and I know this worked for me, knowing there are people within the school situation, if it's online, you know, explain it to Facebook or wherever, or some of your friends online, things. Knowing there are people out there that have got your back, even if it carries on, makes a whole load of difference. It also helps you. Because I have found, even to this day, if I keep things locked up here, I get confused. Yeah, because up here is a melting pot of many, many, many different things. And they can, you know, a bit like if you're making a stew or something like that, they get mixed together and they don't look like their original form, so to speak. So explaining to someone, explaining to yourself, you know, what's going on, how you're feeling, especially how you're feeling, you know, it helps you identify that component to what's going on up here. And it frees you up to dealing with it. And so that's why explaining to whoever it is, it's so good. The third letter of SEAL is A, and that stands for acknowledge. And this is quite a complex one, because I've addressed it slightly just now in Explain, and that's acknowledging how you feel. But it's also acknowledging how the person who's bullying you feels. And this might sound like a strange one, because what you've got to remember is that the person that is bullying you isn't evil. It is easy for us to remember, or think rather, that they are, because it explains a lot. But things aren't that simple. And also, it's harder to think that they're not evil, because them being evil makes sense. It simplifies things, and things aren't that simple. But acknowledging that they have something going on in their lives that is causing them to bully you. And it's nothing to do with you. This is the key. It has nothing to do with you, but something in their lives. Now, I could probably name about 10 or 15 people who bullied me. And I can name now 10 of those people and identify why they bullied me. And it's always something in their lives. And so acknowledge, you don't need to know what it is. That may come, that may not come. But acknowledging that there's something going on in that person's life can help you incredibly. And knowing that can also make you aware of what of them. And it may be that you can identify what she is and help them. And you could turn that animosity between you into some sort of friendship. However, and I'm going to get this onto this in the last lesson as well, it is important to remember you don't have to be friends with them. An awful lot of society says, oh, you must get on with everyone. And especially in these days of Facebook and stuff where everyone's your friend. You don't have to. In fact, sometimes having fewer friends but truer friends is far greater than having lots of friends and faker friends. And so to identify, it may be that you do want to be friends with this person. It may be that you were friends with them in the past and something has gone on that has caused you to fall out and bullying to occur. But it's not always the case. And so if you don't want to be friends with them, acknowledge that. Identify that. Tell other people, I don't want to be friends with them. It is okay not to be friends with them. So we get on to the last letter. And the last letter is lock. Now this one might sound like a bit of a strange one, but it does make sense in the things. And that is locking in what you have decided. You will come under a lot of peer pressure, as I sort of explained in the latter part of the acknowledge section. You'll come under a lot of peer pressure to make a different decision to what you think is right. And that pressure can be hard to deal with at times. But if you have locked in, right, I don't want to be that person. I don't want to be associated with that bully. I don't want to be friends with that person. Stay true to what you have decided. But when I said that it's okay not to be friends with someone, that is true. But it is not okay to be nasty to them in return. You see, you can be nice to someone and not be friends with them. You can be civil to someone and not be friends with them. You can just ignore them. But an awful lot of time people think that if you aren't friends with them, you've got to be nasty. But that's not always the case. It might not be the best relationship for you to have, even if bullying doesn't go on. It might be that they're there, but you just you talk to them occasionally, but you just stay your distance. So, but locking in that decision to say, this is who I am. So this is this is who they are. This is how we're going to work. That really is the best decision you can make, and can help you focus on the important people, the important things in your life, and that will help you achieve your goals in life far quicker than holding on to resentment, holding on to anger and whatever. I hope you found this video useful. If you have, please visit my Facebook page, which is facebook.com/strengthrestored, and click on the sign up link, because if you sign up to our mailing list, you'll get what I just said in a fact sheet at the end of the month. If you're watching this after September, just send us a message and we will send you out the link to the fact sheet. The important thing with all of this is that it can be used in other forms. This is a anger management, a diffusing bullying method, and a conflict resolution method. You could use this to help someone else. And so the fact sheet will go into all those sorts of details. Thanks. Go to our Facebook page. We'd be delighted to have you follow us. You'll find these videos come up when they are published. The newsletter will send you out the videos once a month. And we'd just love to engage with you. If you are being bullied, please drop us a line. We'll try and help you if we can. We might end up just sending you to someone else who's better suited. Maybe you're in the USA and we'll send you to someone in the USA or something like that, but we'll try and help you any way we can. We are here for you. I do look forward to hearing from you or seeing you over at Facebook or Twitter at strengthrestored.twitter. But for the time being, I will see you next time.